One, here we go. All right, so we got Marcus Semien here in the greatest uniform ever. The Blue Jays, the old light blues. We love it. So this was a slider, just so you know. So he was a little bit out in front. And if we look at where he made contact, holy cow, that is way out in front. That is how you save swings. When you're able to be that early, now, granted, it's going to look more out in front because of the angle. This is taking from slightly behind the batter, okay? It was hard to find a perfect side view, but regardless, this is well out in front of his front foot. It's a breaking ball, and the catcher is kind of reaching out, so it's not like an inside breaking ball. You know, it's probably center cut, you know, maybe ball, you know, four or five out there towards the outside part of the plate. But he's able to launch that. So what's cool about this, let's talk about contact. And we talked about launch angle, right? We talked about how he's hitting the ball. You know, his average launch angle was 20-something degrees, right? It was a little bit higher. So I'm going to draw a line on the trajectory of this pitch from this angle. So you can see it's closer to 9 degrees, right? Our fastballs are usually around 4 degrees, okay? But where does his barrel go? Notice how his barrel goes just slightly underneath. So one frame before contact, I'm going to put a circle on where his barrel is. And you can see it's barely underneath. Now, that location is a pretty good place to make contact. On a breaking ball or a fastball, you know, hitting it closer to your front foot, if it's middle away, like, he's not on plane there, but he could be on plane there. Okay, so this would be, you know, where he's exposed a little bit. However, in the next frame, he comes up slightly, and I'll put a number on that. From that dot to contact, he swung up at 15 degrees, got the bottom half of the ball, and then that ball launched it. Good Lord, it's so high. It was probably 35 to 36 degrees off the bat. Okay, so he came from underneath. This is more of a true power hitter's, but it's slight. A true power hitter's approach where that barrel gets a little bit underneath the pitch plane, which you want it to do a little bit, and then he comes back up. But the cool part is, as he comes back up, he extends through. So look at his extension point. This is so good. So this is a guy that, this is why you don't have to swing up that much to hit balls in the air. His right hand and his barrel are actually facing down, and his right palm is still up. So that barrel is still below his hands. Now, if he would have got back here to this frame and flipped his wrist over, his barrel would have gone up like that. Okay, and then what would happen, he would end up topspinning that to the pull side. So this is a great example of, hey, if you swing up too much at contact, he could have hit a two-hopper to the third baseman. But because he stayed flat, he didn't swing down. Don't get me wrong there. Like, he's just swinging up less. But a lot of people that far out in front are going to be 20 degrees or more with their attack angle. And he was only at 15 that far out in front. That's really good. So now, if this was a fastball, okay, there's a fastball coming in. Now, it's not, so, you know, don't get upset. But if it's a fastball, that ball is only going to drop, say, 4 degrees at that level. Okay, so it would be on this plane, and you could see he would be exposed even more. Now, if you look at where his barrel is here, okay, he would be exposed more. Maybe that's why he got more fastballs this year. Maybe it's not. I don't know. Nobody knows except for the people that were calling the pitches. Okay, so when I look at his swing, and I see things like this, even though it was a breaking ball, it's a really nice swing on a breaking ball, but I don't know if this is a sustainable swing. I don't know if this is a sustainable guy for 7 years that's going to hit more than 30 home runs a year, that's going to hit over 260. I'm not sure, it might be. But for 7 years, for 3 years, no brainer. For 7 years, because what happens is you have to have elite quickness to make these little adjustments. When your swing's not on, and we're looking at one swing here, by the way. Okay, so I'm judging all of this on one swing, which you should never do. But based on this swing and some of the other swings that I did see on the internet, you know, there are holes in this swing, and there's holes in everybody's swing. You know, there's holes. There's not holes in like five guys' swings in Major League Baseball. Okay, so. And Jim, okay? But breaking this swing down fundamentally, Okay? Fundamentally, I'm going to bring him from... It's excellent, by the way. From stride to toe touch. Okay? Just so good. Front shoulder is still down. Knob is still kind of back towards the catcher. He's still got good separation between his elbows and forearms here. I bring him to heel plant. Front shoulder is still down. Hands are still back. Top of the top hand is at the ear. Back shoulder is still up. There's a gap. There's an opening here between his elbow and his ribs. Then when he goes to rotate, watch how quiet his elbows are. We talk about this a lot, right? Okay, as he rotates, you know, there's still good separation between these elbows and forearms. Okay, the bat's, this is what I really like. This bat stays up kind of by his ear. Okay, there's no dump in this swing. There's no dump. That's what I like about this swing is he may have been underneath this pitch, but he didn't dump the barrel to get underneath it. Okay, there wasn't any mechanical issue that caused him to go underneath it. He just kind of got underneath it, maybe because his mindset is, you know, I'm trying to get under pitches, which is maybe why his average attack angle was so much higher this year. Maybe that was his thought process. If I miss, I'm going to foul it back. And he did. I looked at a few at-bats today, and he fouled a lot of fastballs back, you know, this year. If you go back and see it, I'm sure he did because he was just trying to get under stuff. So what is the key to good hitting? Hey, I'm getting fastballs. I'm fouling them off. Maybe he goes into a slump, right, where he had a rough month. And he's like, you know what? I got to, instead of my barrel coming in this way to this pitch, so I'm drawing lines now, Jim. I know you can't see them yet. But instead of having a plane that looks like that, maybe his plane comes in a little shallower, like this, and like this, and like that. Okay? And then all of a sudden, instead of having a rough couple weeks or a rough couple months of fouling off good pitches, now he's hitting line drives back through the middle. Maybe now he's hitting line drives into right center. And then he's feeling good about himself. And then all of a sudden we can start hitting for more power again. And that's the old adage. Oh, you're in a slump, take a few back through the middle. Right? That sounds stupid in today's age, right? It does. Like, people don't do that anymore. But why did that get you out of slumps? Because it simplified everything. Because you weren't trying to overswing and drive balls out of the park. You were just trying to control the barrel to hit a line drive back through the middle. And probably by doing that, you made this automatic little swing adjustment between the top plane I drew here and the bottom. The bottom plane is the one he's on. Okay? May have come in a little bit back here. I may have goofed a little bit. But you can see he drops down to that other arrow. If he would have stayed up from this arrow to that arrow, okay, I'll just kind of draw it like that. If he would have flattened off that one frame, he likely would have minimized his slump just a little bit more. Okay, so again, that's kind of a lot of information and little things, but the moral of the story is the guy's got a good swing. He's got a good path and great extension. His front knee didn't straighten out here probably because he was out in front, right? We talked about that. He was out in front a little bit on this breaking ball. How cool is it to be out in front a little bit on a breaking ball and still hit a home run? Okay, that's why extension without, you know, adjusting the barrel too much, without flipping, you know, or having a right hand connection is so very important.